The numbers are very good this time, so the stock is up in the green right now, up about 2-odd%. You have 8G Infra that has emerged as the lowest bidder for a project by RVNL. So 8G Infra is also in the green. But let's get some more stocks going. Zee Entertainment is in focus. Nimesh is here to tell us why. Nimesh, over to you.
Hi, Sonia. Morning. So as a spectator, Zee has started in the red. But you heard Avnish as well talking about whether it's not a big amount. They might go to the NCLT as well. So most likely they're going to file in the NCLT today. That's the feedback that I have. Now, from a brokerage point of view, UBS has put out a note today morning. They maintain a buy. They believe that the amount is very small, of just 83 crores in the dispute. Though it can delay the merger forward. So there could be a further delay as far as the merger with Sony is concerned. But Zee has two options, either to pay off in dispute or file in NCLT. So most likely the NCLT filing should happen today. So Zee will open in the red for sure, but I guess might recover in the second half if there is an NCLT hearing ruling in favor of the Zee.
Okay, all right. Thanks for that, Nimesh. We'll keep an eye on that. Mangalam is back with us to tell us about Sonata. Big acquisition, Mangalam. For starters, the stock is more or less flattish.
Well, it's the biggest acquisition that Sonata Software has made. They've gone ahead and acquired Quant Systems, Inc., which is a Texas-based IT services corporation. Now, it is big primarily on account of the size that they are paying to acquire it. Upfront payment of $65 million, plus additional payment of $95 million over the next 2 years based on some achievements, and additional target-based payments as well. So these are some things that we'll have to monitor, primarily because the scalability is important out here. The company has done almost $37 million worth revenue in CY22, which is a very small amount compared to the company's own Q3 revenues of nearly 2,300 odd crores. They've relinquished their entire cash on the books on this upfront payment. The cash on their books was close to around 600 odd crores. So the margins and scalability is something that we'll have to monitor. The stock has rallied 14% in Feb so far. Let's see where it goes after this acquisition and whether the street considers it to be an overpayment for a company.